What's going on, Coyote Pack? It's a cloudy, rainy day here in central Ohio, which doesn't seem ideal when you're searching for creatures, unless those creatures are worms. Now today I'm gonna show you how to build a worm farm, and the first thing that we need are the worms. So let's go find some.
Nothing like looking for worms in the rain. Check this one out.
That's a good one right there. Got him.
Oh yeah.
That's a good worm right there.
Come here, buddy.
Oh yeah.
Whoa.
They are slippery. That is a Mondo worm right there.
All right, in the container with these guys.
Look at that.
Okay, that's about 50 worms in 30 minutes. I'd say it's time to start construction on our worm farm. Okay, we're back. It is time to put together our worm farm. First, let's take a look at a worm. We've featured worms in the past, and all worms are known as annelids, segmented worms. Leeches and bloodworms are both related to the common earthworm, believe it or not. But we've never featured something as common as the nightcrawler. Now, this is a species that you're very likely to see right in your own backyard. And believe it or not, the nightcrawler is invasive here in the United States. They originally came from Europe, and in the 1800s, settlers brought them over as we were colonizing America. And at this point, there's no way to get rid of the worms. But that's okay, because they're actually doing quite a bit of good for the environment by aerating the soil and re-enriching it with nutrients. Now, this is a rather simple creature, right? It doesn't have proper eyes, but it does have a mouth up front here, and in the back, it does have a butt. And actually, it just pooped on me. So that's gonna answer the question, do worms poop? Yep, they definitely poop. Look, he's pooping all over the table. It's like just a liquid dirt poop. But the worm's primary body structure takes place in the top third of its body. Both its brain, its heart, and its stomach are contained just above this saddle-like looking ring, which is usually purplish or peach in coloration. That's called the clitellum. And this little organ right here creates a thick, viscous mucus. So when a worm lays its eggs, right there is exactly where those eggs come from. Now, the worm has a very long stomach and a wide digestive tract with actually multiple stomachs throughout the body. So all throughout here, you have the digestion that's happening. And when you hold the worm up to the light, you can actually see all of the dirt and rotting plant material that is filtering through its body. And then, like we just saw a second ago, it would poop it out right from its anus, which is at the tip of the tail. Now, these segmented worms are really, really cool. And when they're fully stretched out, you can actually feel these little parapodia that run down the sides of their body. So you may be wondering, how does a worm actually get through the environment? They burrow through tunnels that they make, eating their way through an underground labyrinth. And these little tiny parapodia, those grip onto the dirt walls and propel the animal forward. Now, when it comes to injuring a worm, you may be saying, well, Coyote, can you just hold a worm like that? Certainly. They don't have a proper skeleton like a mammal or a reptile or a bird. In fact, they have no skeleton at all, no exoskeleton. These worms are completely squishy. However, they can be injured if you damage the worm anywhere above the clitellum. If you were to injure its brain, its heart, or its main stomach, yes, it would kill the worm. However, if the worm loses just a piece off of its lower end here, it will eventually rejuvenate. But the cool thing about worms is that they hold an incredibly positive role for the ecosystem by breaking down all of the old decaying plant matter that you find in the forest. Believe it or not, some worms even eat carrion, which is dead animals. I never thought worms could be so fascinating. I'd say at this point, we're probably ready to start building our worm farm. Now, in 30 minutes, I collected, I would say, close to 50 worms, and a lot of them a good size, definitely night crawlers. But building a worm farm isn't nearly as complex as you might think. And just to be clear, there are two very distinct types of worm farms. One is worms for composting. That is not the farm that we're going to be building today. Today we're building the most simplistic worm farm, one where you simply can admire these worms in a little container of your own. Now, what I recommend is a perfectly clear container like this. Placing them in a clear container and then inside of a darker container will help the worms feel more comfortable. And you place your worms inside the container like that to keep them out of direct light. Now, to actually build the farm, first, we need our building materials. We've got our gravel, our sticks, our leaf litter, our worm dirt, and of course, our container of worms. Now, the first thing you want to do is just add a small layer of gravel to the basin of your worm farm. Just gonna spread some of this in here. The finer the gravel, usually the better. And the reason for this is basic drainage. As your worms are eating and as you're watering their environment, that moisture is going to seep down towards the basin of the farm. That also helps all the worm excrement, the worm poop, to seep down to the bottom as well. The next thing you want to add is just a little bit of worm soil. Now remember guys, this is going to get a little messy, so building your worm farm outdoors might be the best play. And you want to make sure that you've got some dirt, it's getting all over the place, some dirt that's real good and crumbly, right? The crumblier dirt is going to be easier for the worms to move through. The next thing you want to do is put down a layer of leaf litter. I went out and just collected some moist leaves. Now I always say the wetter, the better. Damp leaf litter will help it decompose faster. You don't want to just place a bunch of dry leaves in there because that will actually suck moisture out of the worms. Now, as you're putting together your layers, one thing that you're going to want to get is a worm water bottle. But just a little bit of water to spritz throughout the layers is good. You don't want to soak it, but you don't want it to be too dry. Okay, with this leaf litter in place, I'm actually going to add in a couple of sticks. These basic branches that are already dead will actually just create some space for the worms to be able to move around underneath the soil. It's kind of like a worm jungle gym, if you will. And you can just kind of bury these down in there. And now you add on another layer of worm dirt. Sprinkle that in there. Let's put down a little more leaf litter. And last but not least, a container full of worms. You can slowly pick them out one at a time. Place them in different areas, different corners. All right, Mario, you want to get a shot there of the worms up on the surface?
Sure.
Kind of looks like a really disgusting cake with worms. Now, these are very low maintenance pets. All you need to do is a couple times a week, spritz them with your water bottle. Now, before you actually place the lid on top of your worm farm, because you do want to put a lid on it, otherwise they're going to crawl out. You want to either drill or poke some holes into the top. This allows for the flow of oxygen, which means that the worms are able to breathe. And there you have it. You have built a worm farm. Now, this is not a pet that you want to keep for eternity. I would recommend releasing your worms after a few weeks. And if you're not going to release them, at least change out the soil because they will eat out all the nutrients from it. And what's cool about that soil is that you can then actually replace it into your garden or put it into some of your potted plants. And it's full of rich nutrients and minerals that the worms have created through their poop. How cool is that? And there you go. That's your worm farm. Now, I can sense you're probably a little skeptical, saying to yourselves, Coyote, what can you really do with a worm farm? Guys, worms make great pets. You can take them to the park, you can take them on the playground, you can watch TV with them. All in all, worms make great pets. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave. Stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure. You guys want to go watch some Netflix? All right, sounds good. Mario just shook his head. His research had told him this was going to be very painful. This is the best part, I'm telling you.
I know, and then Mario came into the office. He was like, you know what I've got for lunch today? I'm like, what? He's like, I got turkey sandwich. I'm like, there's no way.
I got him, worms, I got him. Nice. Oh, here we go, Animal Planet Go. Brave the Wild, new episodes, how about that? All right, let's watch Coyote catch some creatures. Mmm, these potato chips are great. You want some? No? How about you, Gary? I don't think so. Sloths don't eat chips.